Hi guys, a very warm welcome from RGP Creations in our lesson 5. For lesson 5, I have taken an A4 size watercolor sheet. Now, watercolor sheet is a little thicker sheet which is approximately 300 GSM. You can take any thick sheet of 300 GSM and above. Now, let me explain what I have done here. I have marked half a centimeter border in pencil, then left half a centimeter. So, this is 1 centimeter. And this is the 1 centimeter border on all sides, because we will be creating a double border because it's a bigger painting. And in the center, I have created this triangular hut. Now let me give you the dimensions. This from here to this line is 8 centimeter. This is 1 centimeter. This distance is 8 centimeter, then 1 centimeter, and this distance is 8 centimeter. So basically, we've divided into 3 8 centimeters with 1 1 centimeters lines in the center. And this way, I have taken 6 centimeter. So this way, I have made this. First and the foremost, we are going to create borders. So as we have created borders in the first 4 lessons, similar borders we are going to be creating in this. Now you can choose any of those borders which you like. Now here, I will be creating the most typical border which is generally done. Lesson in which this way you create slanting lines in this manner. And usually it is very, very close by, very symmetrically it is done. So though this is time consuming, but it looks really pretty. For this particular lesson, since I have taken a white base, you can take white base, light base, any. You can even decide to do it on a canvas sheet if you like. You can do it in your sketchbook. And you can use any black pen which is waterproof and fade proof. So this way. Now, for long lasting purpose, if you want, you can also go in for Micron. For my inner designing work, I will be using my Micron. So that I can even use colors here, because I would want to make this beautiful piece of Sora art for my room, and I would like to frame it up. So that is why I'll be using colors in this particular form of Sora art. So this way we are going to create our border. Okay, now we are going to turn it around. Black doesn't take so long as a white does to dry up, so you can. Now this one, we are going to create a beautiful border. So this way I have done this line. Now, you must be wondering why I have created this line in pencil. This is because I'm creating a typical border of Sora art, in which what happens is in the outer part, triangles are made. Now here, I'm not doing it till the line, I'm making them a little smaller. But if you want, you can make it till the line. I just wanted a reference line, so that all my triangles are of approximately the same height. Now if you want, you can also do these up in color directly using your sketch pens. You can make them longer or thinner as you feel like, but traditionally in most of the Sora paintings that you'll see, you will see a triangular border like this which is colored up. Now here I'll be doing it in plain black. But in case you want to do this in color, you can do it up like this. So now I'm going to simply color it up, and I'm making a spiral for my border squares. Okay, the same triangles I'll be doing here also. Here I'm going to change the triangle just this way, and I'm going to do a typical triangle. So this way, let me finish the border on all sides and show you how it comes out. So I have created the border on all four sides, including the triangles, and see, it's looking very pretty now. I've just done an outline of using a double line of this particular part as well. Now, you can create any kind of a border here also in this area to highlight it. First, let us create a tree pattern in the center. We are going to be using colors here, as I was telling you. So we'll create more branches, and we are going to fill this whole thing using different branches to fill up the tree part. This way we've created the center part, and I'm going to create a simple check pattern as a border here. Like this. So I'm going to create a check border all around. So now I have just drawn the triangles. See, just like we did outside. Now we are going to divide this space into a lot of smaller spaces. So just approximately I've taken this space and I've divided it. And I'm going to first draw a double line. Now Now here again, you can do any border pattern of your choice. And you are going to show a lot of people in the lower part who are celebrating, who are dancing over here. Now let's do another division. So I'm doing a little thinner division this time. Again, I'm going to do a double line. Approximate same division. Okay, so like this, another border pattern will come here. Now we are going to come up with another division. This is a little bigger because we'll be showing the elephant on both the sides. So just draw this. And this portion also, I'm just going to divide it now. So see, we have different divisions. We can add different elements to create a super beautiful painting out here. So now here, let us further divide this into smaller parts. Now this is optional. I'm dividing it into smaller parts because I can create different elements out here. And now we are going to start with creating different elements everywhere. Now you can decide which all elements you want to create here, which kind of people you want to show out here. So first I'm going to be doing my celebration scene. As we are done, we are going to show, you can show anything of your choice. So here I'll be showing people, okay, with the drum. So I'll be showing three people, because see, now I'm drawing a small drum. So those were full figures. In this we are drawing tiny figures, but believe me, ultimately this is going to look super beautiful, and it is. You can easily get it framed for your rooms. You can also create them as lovely gifts to give to your friends and family. So this way, this is the person. Now we can create. Now we can create them as colorful also. Dresses, colorful, because now we want a little dash of color for our rooms. So you can do up the color in the colors of your choice. Now this way, we can create another celebration out here to match the same. So another celebration we have shown here. Now let us draw two elephants out here. Now elephant is typically drawn, so you can draw any form in which the elephant. So here it is very geometric in shape when you draw the elephant. Now here you can show that the person is so this way, the elephant. Now you can either show that the person is sitting on top, like this. Now we can make a person sit on top. So this is the person on top. So we've made same elephants on both sides. Now here we will make a lot of people. Now all these people can be standing in a straight line, or you can make any celebration scene here to depict more celebration, more festivity, etc. Now the top line first we are going to make people just in a straight line. So right in the center first, let us see. Now here we will make some daily life that is there. So we can make first, okay. Now we'll be making two people. So this is a pot which is hanging in between. So this way, this is showing some forms of daily life. We can fill up the gaps, putting some pots. Now in this part, we will make the sun. सेम वे अगर ने किया। Now in this one we are going to make an animal. Now same animal we make again. Okay, we are going to repeat that here. Here we are going to make the flying birds. Now here we are going to make few people who have the pot on their heads. So here we will have a horse. We can have a horse. So the body is going to be made with triangles. Now we can have a person here. Now here I'm going to make a tree and some grass. So now you can make the tree in any way. Here I am making two trees. Now here we are going to create the hut kind of a structure like we did in one of our big paintings. Here we will make a small bullock cart. Now here I'm going to make another kind of tree like we had created. So like this, we have drawn different elements in this one single picture. Now let us take our colors. You can take any colors of your choice, whether you want acrylic, you want poster colors, or you want to use your brush pens, sketch pens, color pencils, whatever you want to use, you can use. Now here I'll be using my brush pens. These are the brush pens of Domes company. You can use any company brush pens for this particular purpose. I'll be using really vibrant colors because I want the painting to stand out. So you can use any colors, particular colors of your choice when you're doing this. So I'll keep a consistency by painting the upper part of the human figure with red and the lower part with green or blue. So the best part about Micron is that Micron is not going to bleed if you use your brush pens on top. So it's gonna give a super beautiful effect. You can use your alcohol markers also if you like. Any colors of your choice are good. So here I'm working on the element of contrast, where my borders, my in-between borders, if you have seen, I have done them in different kinds of lining. I'm using colors only in certain places to add the zing and the to enhance the festive spirit of the entire painting. Now I'll be using my green first. So I'm gonna use my green in the tree. Alternatively, I'm not doing the entire thing green. Same way here, we'll do the leaves. So now I have completed the green. Now we are just going to add brown using a for the branch. Pots, whenever there are pots or instruments that you want to color, I'm doing the color using my brown here. Now for the lower part of the body, I'm doing blue. You can do green as well. Now the elephant. Now for the elephant also, I'm thinking I'll be using my dark blue color, because black will become really dark, so I'm using the dark blue color. Now in this way, you can see that our beautiful Sora painting, which is a complete depiction, is ready. Now you can get it framed for your homes. Do let me know which element in this painting you like the most.
Do like our video and subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to press the notification button so that you can be notified as soon as we put a new video or our live on our channel.